वेलकम अगेन बच्चे लोग, होप यू ऑल रिवाइज्ड द प्रीवियस सेशन प्रॉपरली। यस, इट वाज प्योरली कनेक्टेड विद टाइप्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स एंड इट्स डेबिट क्रेडिट रूल्स। इफ यू ऑब्जर्व, आई टोल्ड यू टू मैटर्स आर वेरी एक्सट्रीमली इंपॉर्टेंट, टू मैटर्स, वन टाइप ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन्स and its rules, second type of accounts and its debit credit rules. First, to remember and understand that things, second, even more important, to apply it into practical questions. Now if you observe, for type of transaction and its rules, we spare a special session for that. Remember, in that session we didn't discuss anything else like vouchers, like terminologies, nothing specifically for type of transaction, cash, credit and its rules. Okay, in the same way, last session dedicatedly devoted for only one thing, that is type of accounts and its debit credit rules. Okay, after type of transaction we started doing practice. We solved two questions, one over here, second was in your homework, and finally we revised it, we solved it over here also. Okay, in the same way, for type of accounts and its rules, again let's go through the practical one, and then by merging both type of transaction, type of accounts, by merging both, by having a combination of both, we will start dual effect of transaction. Okay, so today in this session we are going to continue with one of the question of your textbook, that is illustration 4, that is illustration 4 which is given on page number 33. Okay, we are going to make a table. See, don't, again let me tell you this illustration, don't just copy from the textbook, because in so many here you can do a copy, because only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 you are going to write. Even here that is also very okay, because we are going to write from the question itself. Here also nobody can make any change, but here textbook says something else, I am going to explain maybe something else. Something else does not mean that textbook is saying asset and I am saying goods. Ultimately both are saying the same thing, but they may not clear the things in simpler words, where we are going to simplify the matters. We are going to explain it in detail. Okay? So again let me tell you, you are not supposed to do just copy work. Is that clear? Sure. Okay. Draw a table like this, having different columns like number, then name of account, then type of account, and explanation. See, these are the same columns having in book also. Okay. I'm not going to solve the entire one, because there are 40 accounts, so cannot be covered in a single bold framework, but definitely you can come to know how we are doing it. Here instead of content, methodology is much more important. If you know how to prepare it, then it becomes very easy for you. Okay, so let's start
First of all, they gave different names like No Jewel Commerce College account, drawings account, cash account, donation account, and so many things. Let's check one by one. First one, that is No Jewel College account. No Jewel. Say it's a commerce college, science college, arts college, does not make any difference. No Jewel College account, type of account. While thinking of this column, you have three options: personal, real, nominal. Okay? What do you have to think? No Jewel College account. Whether it's a living person or artificial person? If yes, personal account. No Jewel College account. Is it goods? Is it asset? If yes, real account. No Jewel College account. Is it an expense or an income? Then nominal account. Okay? Here you are going to write the type. And why you think it's a personal account, why you think it's a real account, why you think it's a nominal account, that reason you are going to write in this column, explanation. Okay? So here, No Jewel College account, actually it is a personal account. Okay? And obviously, explanation. Artificial person. Clear? So again, what I wanted to say, here the type of account, and here, if personal, living person or artificial. If real, goods or assets. Nominal, expense or income. Clear? Second one, good one, you can say drawings account. Drawings account. Say it's an illustration, you can also go through it easily in advance, but not good for you. So better option while studying this, you can keep something on the answer. Okay? You can keep a pouch or a notebook on the answer. So only question you can see. So don't feel tempted to go through it. Okay? Drawings account. It is personal account. Why is it so? Okay. What do we mean by drawings? See, you have to understand some particular things. Again, let me tell you, it will not be given in the textbook every time. So do concentrate. What do we mean by drawings? Terminologies. What do we mean by drawings? Very, very simple. Whenever honor withdrawn goods, services, asset or money for his personal use, monetary value of it is known as drawings. Again, whenever owner of the business withdrawn money, goods, assets or services for his personal use, monetary value of it is known as drawings. So indirectly what we can say, drawings is basically owner's account. Okay? If you remember, I told you 3-4 times, business is not going to write owner's name. Okay? So, owner's matter, business, whatever deal with owner, is reflected by two words. Drawings, where from business to owner relation is there. Second, capital, where owner to business is there. In capital, owner is investing into business. In drawings, from business, owner withdraw. Okay? So capital and drawings. Do remember, capital and drawings. These two are always owner's account. And so naturally, owner is a person, so personal account. Here you can write owner's account. Okay? A better option. You can write living person, that is also okay. But if you write owner's account, it is easy for you to remember it. Okay? Next, cash account. Very simple. Cash. Cash is always considered as an asset. An asset always in real account. Okay? Better option if you write whenever asset is there. It's better if you write the type of asset. Current asset, non-current asset, fictitious asset, intangible asset, tangible asset, like that. If you write it like that, even your concept will be more and more clear. Current asset. Because the balance, cash balance, whatever the cash you are having, fluctuating frequently. It will not happen like that. That whatever the cash we are having will be there for the entire year. Akku varas cash mein changes na thai. It's impossible in business. So naturally, the asset which are fluctuating constantly always known as current asset. Okay? Fourth one, next. That is donation account. Okay? In business, it happens that sometimes we are giving donation for earthquake relief fund or in Prime Minister relief fund for any disease or any man-made calamity or anything like that. So donation is always an expense for the firm. Normally, donation we are not receiving because we are doing business. Clear? So, because it's an expense, it is nominal account. It is an expense. Is that clear? Next, fifth, that is machinery account. Which type of account is this? Personal. No. Real. Yes, it's real. Why it is real? Because machinery is an asset. So, can say non-current asset. Okay, next one, that is land account. Again, land is an asset. Again, the same will not be fluctuating. So non-current asset. Okay, I think the methodology how we are writing is now very clear to you. Am I right? Just the serial number, then the name of account given in the question itself, then type of account we have to decide, and why we decided that type is to be written in explanation form. Okay, seventh, that is Raj Medical Store. Raj Medical Store account. Naturally, it's a name, so personal account, because it is a non-living, artificial, so you have to write artificial person. Okay, next one, eight, that is salary account. Very, very simple. If you remember, I discussed this particular in last lecture. Salary account always nominal. Why is it so? Because always it is an expense. If you remember, I told you we are not going to receive the salary, because we are always an owner when we are writing the accounts. So salary is an expense for us. Then for 10th, it was 8th rather than 9th, carriage inward account, something new for you. Yes. Inward account. First of all, what do we mean by carriage inward? What do we mean by carriage inward? Then we can still say whether it's personal, real or nominal. What do you mean by carriage? Can you tell me? What do you mean by carriage? Carriage is nothing else. It is transportation expense. Transportation expense of goods. To move goods from here to there, whatever the transportation expense we paid is known as carriage in accountancy. Okay? Now, inward. Inward means when we purchase goods, goods comes in. When we purchase goods, goods comes in. And so, whatever the expense we are paying at that time, transportation expense, at the time of purchasing goods, is known as carriage inward. Okay? Naturally, it's an expense. So, nominal account is expense. Now, carriage inward. Whenever we are paying transportation expense for purchasing goods, known as carriage inward. Can you say anything on the basis of this? Again, let me repeat. When we are paying transportation expense for purchasing goods, it is known as carriage inward. Now reply. Whenever we are paying transportation expense at the time of selling goods, it is known as carriage outward. Because purchasing goods, goods comes in, so inward. When we are selling goods, goods goes out. So it is known as outward. It will be here in this question. But along with this, if you understand, it becomes easy for you. Because when inward, it is a purchasing expense. When outward, it is a selling expense. One more question. You may feel, sir, expense means expense. What makes difference when we are saying it's a purchasing expense or when we are saying it's a selling expense? I don't think so. You may feel like that. But friends, you are very new to this stream, commerce. So don't take it lightly. Means don't consider like this. Expense means expense. No. You have to specify it. Why? Because in further studies, in 11th only, the last step of accounting cycle, final accounts. In final accounts, if purchasing expense are there, you have to write in different format. If sales expense are there, you have to write in different format. Okay? So, from the very beginning, if you understand very clearly whether it is a purchasing expense or a selling expense, if inward word is there, it's always connected with purchasing expense. If outward word is there, it's always connected with selling expense. So if you understand these things from the beginning, then only it becomes very easy for you at that time when we are going to start that chapters. Or else you have to do this kind of things in that chapter. So it becomes a bit lengthy because you have to do special things of that chapter as well as to clear these fundamentals also at that time. Okay? So better to understand at present only. Next one, tank, furniture account. I think now you all are expert enough. Don't be all confident now. But can be a confident person. Furniture account. Which type of account? Only three options. Personal, real, nominal. Which type of? It is real account. Okay? Furniture. Why it is real account? Because furniture is an asset. Non-current asset. Okay? Next, that is carriage outward account. We just discussed the same carriage outward account. Inward and outward, both are always an expense. It is an expense. Is it clear? Yes, the things are very easy. Stationery account, 12th one. In business, naturally we need so many times we need some stationery items like pen, like bill book we printed or whatever it is. Say for example, computer papers and so many things. Stationery items. Take care, they will say stationery expense. They can say stationery item also. Okay? If there are stationary expense, then it becomes very easy for you. The word expense is given. But if there is a stationary account, then also meaning will not change. To will be an expense, so it's always a nominal account. It is an expense. Is it okay? Next one, wages account 13. Whether we use the word wages or labor, one and the same, always nominal account and always an expense. Always an expense. Please take care. I also wish, and let's pray, that wages should never be an income for you people. Wages means majuri. मजूरी इनकम क्या रे थाय जरा अपन मजूर होए तो बराबर सो लेट मी प्रे दैट वेजेस शुड ऑलवेज बी एन एक्सपेंस फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस क्लियर प्लीज एंड एक्सपेंस Okay, 14th, copyright, okay, you know that, copyright, what is it? I'm not going to explain it present, I'm not even asking you, but can you tell me, copyright, which type of account is it, without looking at the answer, mind well, without looking at the answer, can you tell me? Copyright, which type of account? No. Why not? It's very, very simple. Copyright is always real. Why real? Because copyright is a type of asset. A type of asset means which type of asset? It is intangible asset. Intangible asset. Is it clear? Now, due to the limitation of board frame, I'm not going to continue writing over here, but we are solving the entire question. Okay? So do concentrate. Do concentrate for remaining 15-20 minutes. Copyright. It's a real account, intangible asset. Then interest received account. Interest received account. What do we mean by interest received? Whenever the word paid or received is there, it's always, always, always nominal account. Because paid or received word itself suggests either it's an expense, paid word is there, or it's an income when we received it. Okay? So here, 15, interest received account is nominal account. Because it is an income. It is an income. Next one is Union Bank account. Union Bank account. Now, Union Bank is the name. And whenever names are there, always it is personal account. Okay? So, Union Bank account. Personal account, artificial person, naturally, it cannot be the name of a living person. 17, rent paid account, very, very simple again, rent paid, nominal account. See, I'm not going to explain much about this, because it's very simple, it's a wastage of time, if I spend 5 minutes to explain what is rent paid. Okay, rent paid account, word paid suggests it's an expense, and because it's an expense,
always
a nominal account. So type of account nominal, in explanation you can write is an expense. Reliance share account, a very good one, a very good one. So many students are committing mistake in this type of things. Reliance share account. Here by looking at the word Reliance, you feel it's a personal account, but no, this is not Reliance account, this is a share account. But which company is the share? Reliance. So we have to identify on the basis of share, not on the basis of name. Okay? And share is an investment. Share is a type of investment. Investment is always considered as an asset. Okay? So, Reliance share account is a real account, and in explanation you can write it is investment. You can even write non-current oblique current asset. Because if you invest for a short time, it is considered as current asset. If you invest for a longer time, it is considered as non-current asset. We can have two types of investments. Long-term investment and short-term investment. Long-term investment is always falling under the category of non-current asset, and short-term investment naturally it is current asset. Okay, so Reliance share account, very simple, real account, non-current / current investment or asset. Next one, 19th, discount received account. Again, what received is there? Again, whenever received, an income, paid, an expense. So discount received, nominal account, and it is an income or gain, you can write. 20th, 20, Ahmedabad branch account. Ahmedabad branch account. Now branch, again, person, but artificial person. So personal account and artificial person. We are almost at 50%. Yes, out of 40, 20 we completed. Next, 21st, important one. Bad debt account. Bad debt account. Can you tell me which kind of account is this? Bad debt account. Personal? Is it person's name? No. Artificial person? No. Real account? Is it goods? No. Is bad debt an asset? No. But one thing, what is bad debt? If you are not knowing that, it is impossible that you can come to know. You have to bluff. Dopaj marwata hai. What is bad debt? When we cannot recover partial or full amount from the debtors. Such amount is known as bad debt. It is a loss for the business. Loss means it is a nominal account. Okay? It is not an expense, it is a loss. What is the difference between expense and loss? For expense, you have to pay, and for that you are receiving something. If you are paying salary, you are receiving service of that person for the month. If you are paying electricity bill, an expense, you are receiving electricity facility for the month.
But loss means you are not getting anything in exchange of it. Okay? Is it clear? Bad debt is a kind of loss. So it is a nominal account. Okay? Bad debt is a nominal account. Clear? Nominal account, in explanation you can write, it is a loss. Karnavati club account. Again, very simple. The name is given, Karnavati club. The name is given, so personal account and personal account, but the explanation is artificial person. Artificial person. Okay, next, debtors account. What do you mean by debtors account? Means which type of account is it? Debtors account, personal account, real account, or nominal account? Debtor means the person from whom we are going to receive the amount of credit sales. Debtor means the person. When we are saying the person, always debtor account is a personal account. Okay? In explanation, you can write living oblique artificial person. Living or artificial. Because if we are talking about you people, then living person. But if we sold to some store or somewhat like that, to some institute, then the opposite party is artificial person. Okay? So debtor, always personal account, type of account. An explanation, real, rather living or artificial person. Next one, 24. Goods distributed as sample account. Now here the word goods is there. But actually, why we are distributing goods as sample? For the advertisement. Okay? So this is nominal account. This is nominal account. Because it is considered as advertisement expense. Goods distributed as free sample, considered as advertisement expense. Because it is an expense, it is nominal account. Then creditors account. If debtors account is personal account, naturally creditor account is also personal account. And the same living or artificial person. Debtors and creditors opposite. The type of account will remain same. Purchase and sales, opposite, but both are goods. So type of account will remain same. Okay? Income and expense, opposite, but both are indirectly falling under the name of nominal account. Is that clear? Next one. Factory expense account. The word itself suggests factory expense account. So naturally it is nominal, it is an expense. Nilamban account, 27. Nilamban account. The word, the party's name is given, Nilamban account. Personal account, living person, the name itself suggests living person. Depreciation account, one more good thing. Depreciation means what? Constant and gradual reduction in the value of fixed asset is known as depreciation. This is for the fourth time I am saying this. Again, fifth time. Constant and gradual reduction in the value of fixed asset is known as depreciation. Is that clear? Sure? Okay.
So let's continue with it. Depreciation, always a nominal account, always a nominal account. It is an expense for the business. It is an expense. It is not a loss because we are using this asset. Okay? And so the value of asset decreased. So it's not a loss, it's an expense. So nominal account. Gujarat government account. Again the name. So personal account and Gujarat government, not a living. So artificial person. Next one. Received bank interest account. What received say? Received or paid. Whenever it is given, always nominal. Now if it's received, it is an income. If paid, it's an expense. So received bank interest account, nominal account, it is an income. Goods given for advertisement account. Again the similar one. Again the similar one. Okay? Advertisement. So it is an expense. Goods given as free sample, goods given as advertisement, both are falling under the same category. So nominal account, it's an expense. Dividend received account. Dividend received account. Okay. Dividend received, word received said, it's an income. So nominal account, an income. Then almost on the verge of completion, 33rd. Commission received, the similar, nominal account, it is an income. Goodwill account, same like copyright. There are four intangible assets: goodwill, patent, trademark, copyright. Please do remember, goodwill, patent, trademark, copyright. So goodwill is an intangible asset, and so naturally it is real account. Commission allowed account. Allowed means paid. Commission received account, nominal account. So naturally commission paid account, also a nominal account. Clear? Because it is nominal account, it's an income or expense. Now here commission paid word is given, allowed means paid. So it is an expense. Clear? Next one. Bills receivable account. Bills receivable account. Now this will fall under two categories. It can be an asset also. It can be a personal account also. Yes. If you consider it as an asset, then it is real account. But advisable to consider it as a personal account. Why? Let me tell you the reason. There are two words. One, bills receivable. Another, bills payable. Now, bills payable is always a liability. And liability is always a personal account. Liability is always a personal account. Always. Okay, you can write in your diary also. Liability always personal account. Now, if bills payable is a liability, it is a personal account. So for bills receivable, if you feel it's a real account, you may get confused. So it is advisable that whenever bills account are there, it is always personal account. Here bills receivable is a document through which we are going to receive the amount from the person. It is somewhat like debtors, somewhat like debtors. And so bills receivable we are going to consider it as a personal account, amount receivable from person. In explanation, you can write amount receivable from person. Okay. Next one, 37. Discount allowed account. Discount received account is naturally again nominal account. So discount allowed account also a nominal account, but not a gain. Discount allowed means we are giving discount to someone. We are giving discount to someone. So it is a kind of loss for us. It's not an expense actually, a kind of loss. So discount allowed, nominal account, it is a loss. Stock account, now opening stock, closing stock, two types of stock can be possible. But both these stock are basically goods. So real account. If it is closing stock, it should be considered as an asset. But you can consider stock account, type of account, real account, type of account, real account. And in explanation you can write stock is a current asset. It is a current asset because stock constantly fluctuates. If we sold, stock decreased. If we purchased, stock increase. Okay. Capital account. In the beginning I say drawings and capital. These two are owner's account. An owner is always a living person. So capital account, personal account, it is owner's account, you should write. And the last one, purchase account. Very, very simple. When we are using the word purchase, when we are using the word sales, always it shows goods. And goods means real account. Because in real account, we are covering goods and assets. So purchase account, type of account, real account. And in explanation you can say it is goods account, or you can say purchase of goods, purchase of goods made, like that. In explanation word goods must be there in this case. Okay, here we completed 40 names of account. 40. Thing is enough. It's enough. But enough does not mean enough for you people. For me it's enough. For you, still something to be done. Still something to do. So let me tell you, first of all, if you have any question, queries regarding this, feel free to ask me. But before that, do go through it once again and then ask me. Now, if you do not have any problem, then in homework, as an assignment, you have to solve illustration 5. Okay, illustration 5. Is there any problem? Same pattern, huh? See, illustration 7. It's already given in the textbook, the answers. But I personally believe you are not going to copy it from it. If you do it, I'll not come to know. Okay? But always advisable, do it by your own. Follow these things properly. And if any doubts, always welcome. We are ready for that. Clear? So, in
next session, we are going to merge both. Merge both. Which two? Type of transaction and its rules, type of accounts and its rules. And we will start dual effect of transaction. But before that, without fail, do revise this and solve illustration 5. I'm giving illustration in homework because in exercise, this kind of questions are not there. But it's very important. Okay? There are 50 names. We sold 40 to a year and 50 in homework. If we sold 90, that's enough. But if you sold by your own. Okay? So, next time, meeting with this, I need to move further with dual effect. Till then, take care of yourself, be happy, be safe.